over the last few months, I've probably created thousands of different sticker images ever since GPT came out. I was addicted to figuring out the art of creating the very best stickers. I'd upload them to Redbubble, I'd even edit them and upload them to TeePublic, and I'd even use them and create collages of all these stickers combined and put them on things like all over print t-shirts. But one thing I've been really focused on is the style that I've kind of created with my stickers. Hey guys, welcome to a new video. If you want to be able to create amazing stickers like the one you're seeing here, keep watching this video. I'm going to teach you exactly how I was able to do it. So, over the last few months, I've been addicted to making stickers. In fact, you could go to my YouTube channel and you could see a few videos of different times where I made some stickers, right? And I kind of shared publicly how I'm pretty much addicted to them. And using them for Redbubble, editing the images, uploading them to TeePublic, and even incorporating some of these sticker styles with different texts to make different shirts has been something that I've been inspiring to me and something that I've been working on. But with that being said, after like literally maybe about a good 4 months, I've been making so many stickers that I kind of came up with my own style. And I came up with a style of this kawaii, colorful type style that I can't really kind of fully describe. I don't have the words to fully describe it. I'll throw some images up on the screen so you guys can see the different style of image that I like to create. And what I did was I put them all up in a file, all of the different images. And I think we came up with over 2,200 and I think like 13 images. And that's a lot of images. And what we did was we took the images, we minified them, and we uploaded them to GPT. And we created a GPT, a custom GPT, that basically sucks the data out from these images, understanding how they were created, and then creates images in the likeness of them. And what this is just a trained version or a trained AI that can create this kawaii style. So let's go ahead and let me show you how to get started. So the first thing you're going to want to do is go over to the GPT Explore page. If you use the GPT Pro, or I believe it's called the Plus, you can access this page where you can access different trained GPTs. And really what these GPTs are, they're nothing more than fine-tuned models. Basically a trained element of an AI that kind of understands a little bit more of what you are looking for. So I went ahead and created this GPT model, I guess you can say, where you guys can access it as well by just typing in sticker maker, and it's called the RB sticker maker. In fact, you could actually type in RB sticker maker. And the one that looks like this with the Redbubble logo, but more importantly, it says buy autopilotpassiveincome.com. That's the Redbubble sticker maker that I have personally created for you guys, and something that, like I said, I've trained it with a ton of different images, and you guys are going to love it. So all you have to do is click on it, right? And now you are literally accessing it. So here it says state the image you want me to create. All you have to do is, instead of clicking this, just type in the image that you literally wanted to create. So let's go ahead and start off with something really simple. So I'll type in a yellow rose, just like this. I'm not going to tell it that says sticker. I'm not going to tell it any other details. I'm just going to simply type in a yellow rose and let's see what it does. Now, remind you, we can go ahead and alter the AI and tell it different things. So if I want the image to be a little bit more complex, I can type in complex yellow rose. If I want it to be more simple, I can type in simple yellow rose. We actually trained it based on those two main words to help it kind of improve results. And look at that image, right? I typed in yellow rose, and look how amazing that is. That is on a different level of how attractive that looks. For those who are out there and you guys create some children's books, or even some children's art, you can absolutely use this for this. And like I said, it's free. If you have already access to the Pro, which most people do for GPT, then you can go ahead and use this with literally no extra cost. It's already built in to the GPT platform. Let's go ahead and type something else. Let's type in just carrot cake. Let's see what it can do if I just type in the word carrot cake, okay? So you could see here, this is something more of what I'm looking for, which is just a cake, piece of carrot on top. Now let's be a little bit more specific with the AI, and let's tell it what we actually want to see. So I'm going to type in a slice of a carrot cake with orange colors and white frosting. So here, guys, with the prompt, I'm a little bit more specific, and I'm creating these more specific prompts so you can kind of see what results will come out of this, which is, once again, I'm just trying to give the AI a little bit more direction with how things go. And keep in mind, I can prompt the AI multiple times with various different instances, and it will, you know, it will come out with different results each and every time. So look at this. This is exactly a very, very cool image that I personally am looking for. This is, like I said, a carrot cake, and remember what we asked for, with orange colors and white frosting. And indeed, it provided just that for us. Let's go ahead and ask it for a image generation ID. So I'll go ahead and type here, I'll say, please provide the gen ID for the image, and the ID is this number right here. And so what I'll do is I'll type in using gen ID, you know, right here, whatever that number is. I'll say using gen ID, and then the code, I will say as inspiration, please provide a chocolate cake in the same style, or a slice of chocolate cake rather, a slice of chocolate cake in the same style with white frosting and chocolate sprinkles. Okay, so let's go ahead and see what it can provide now. Now remember, what we're doing is we're including now really three different elements. The generation ID, which just gives it previous data, that's the element number one. Element number two is the white frosting, and the white frosting and chocolate sprinkles, that's element number two, which is a little bit more complicated because it's really like two elements of one. And then the third element is a slice of chocolate cake. So these are the three kind of pointers that it's kind of understanding, and look, it did a great job. Now, with me personally, guys, an image like this, I might want it to kind of revamp it. I might say, please recreate this image without the face, without the eyes in the slice of cake. So basically, what I'm asking it is I just want it to remove these kind of eyes. Now, keep in mind, it's not going to come out perfect because we're still kind of training it on understanding how to remove these eyes. And over time, the nice thing about this GPT is we can keep popping out these new types. And like I said, it's pretty cool because you guys don't have to pay for anything. But more importantly, we'll kind of create different versions. So as you can see, we're struggling a little bit with the different, you know, these different images. But let's go ahead and create something with eyes. And notice here, like this image didn't have the eyes, but this one did. So we're still working on it, but it is pretty cool so far. So let's create something with eyes. So I'm gonna write a donkey face. So donkey face, that's what I'm asking it to do. A picture or a sticker of a donkey face. Let's see what it can come up with without me really giving it any more details. And once again, this is the nice thing about GPT being trained or being adapted to a certain fine-tuned model, which is the fine-tuned model that I'm training it with. So this is nice. This is okay. Let's type in corgi face. How about that? Let's see what that will come up with. And we can test it out. And like I said, this is great for, like, in my head, like kind of like a children's art style. I think it just fits really well. So if you're out there maybe uploading to Redbubble, this could work for you. If you're looking for some elements that you can edit and utilize and incorporate it within your print on demand, this will be great for you. And it'll all be also great for people who are into the children's books, the art creation. You could even take images like this and turn them into black and white type images and turn them into coloring pages. So simple art like this is perfect for kids to use as coloring books and things like that. And even if you're listening, any moms or dads out here listening, you can take this, and I could do this in future videos if you have kids listening, if you have kids, you can, and they like, you know, doing the whole coloring books, you can turn this into a black and white image. And they could sit there and color this simple, cute image. And it's not too complicated, not too difficult, but it looks great. And I think the kids would love it, in my opinion. Let's go ahead and keep giving it more information. So I could type in here, cute corgi face. Let's see what the difference is between just simply a corgi face and a cute corgi face. Let's see. And then actually next, I want to type in a different kind of prompt, where we can utilize kind of the whole entire animal instead of just the face, so you guys can see how that works as well. But the most things people are going to create, in my assumption, with this kind of plugin for GPT, there we go, this is really nice, right? Look at that. Even gave you a little bit of color palette here, I believe, right? That's pretty cool. But anyways, for something like this, I could see people using this for animals a lot, for different like flowers, for desserts, things like that. Let's go ahead and test something small where we just kind of create another image in a full kind of animal, like a full body of an animal. I'm going to type in here, corgi. Let's see here, corgi with a furry tail, something like that. Let's see. Let's see what it comes up with. And there we go. So you can kind of see how the art is set up.